My name is Frank Coscarano. Welcome to my classroom. This is our mechanics class. At Foothill College, we call it Physics 4A. It's the first quarter in a four-quarter calculus-based physics sequence for science and engineering majors. We're going to do things a little differently than most traditional physics classes. Traditionally, physics is taught in a very linear fashion. First, you learn one topic and you learn it in great detail, completely. And then you go on to the next topic. For mechanics, that would be kinematics, then dynamics, that's forces, then energy, and then momentum. One topic, then the next, in a very linear fashion, going through in detail each one before you start the next one. But really, that's not the way people learn things naturally. Think about when you learned a language or how to use a computer program or how to cook. You learn things kind of in general. You kind of dabble in a lot of different areas at first, and then you build on that and you dig deeper and deeper and add complexity. So that's what we're going to do. We are going to learn all these topics in Physics 4A and mechanics. Those are the four topics: kinematics, dynamics, energy, and momentum. We're going to learn them all on day one on a very rudimentary level. And then as the weeks go on, we're going to dig in deeper and deeper and get a much better understanding of these concepts and build on what we're doing early in the quarter as we move on later into the quarter. The idea here is that this is a much more natural way to learn something, and it helps with a huge pitfall that physics students deal with when they learn in this linear way that's traditional. And that is, how do you know which approach to use when you're solving a certain problem? Because when you're learning things, 1 week you're doing one topic and the next week you're doing another topic, you don't ever have to decide. You know, if you're on your energy week, every problem you're going to see has to do with energy. Then maybe the final exam rolls around and you see a problem and you don't know which approach to use and you're trying to struggle with which approach do I use to solve this problem. Or maybe that doesn't come till you get to a later class. But this way, on day one, you're going to be thinking about which approach do I use, and you gain a much deeper conceptual understanding of how to solve these problems. And I think that'll serve you much better in the long run. The other change we're making with most traditional classrooms is that we will flip our classroom. You've probably taken some classes that follow the flipped classroom format, and that is, you'll see videos of my lectures ahead of time, and then you'll come into class having seen those prepared, and we will do group work and problem sessions when we're together. How many times has this happened to you? You hear a lecture and everything sounds straightforward and you've got your notes and it all makes sense, and then you go home when you're all alone and you start working problems, and all of a sudden there's a problem that's just a tiny bit different than the one that was discussed in class, and you get stuck and you don't know what to do. Well, by flipping the order, you listen to the lecture ahead of time, and really, you don't need other students around for that. That's something you can do on your own with a video. In fact, a video is probably better because you can fast forward over parts you've heard, and you can stop and rewind and listen to something two or three times if you need to. Then that part hopefully will make sense, and you'll come into class thinking you're going to be able to do those problems, and maybe we'll see some problems that are a little bit different and you might get stuck, but you'll have other students around. You'll have me there, and we can work through that and learn how to solve those problems. So flipping the order makes a lot of sense. A lecture is a great way to disseminate information to a lot of people in a very efficient way, but it's not a good way to learn something new. So we'll follow the flipped classroom format here. The other thing I wanted to talk about is textbooks. This style of teaching physics is kind of new, and there really aren't textbooks out there that are available. The textbooks are very traditional, and they follow that linear format I was talking about. So there are a couple of professors that have written relatively short, concise textbooks that follow this format. And we'll use those. Those are available online for free. We will use those. The nice thing about a nice, short, concise textbook is that you'll probably read it. Whereas when you open up a big textbook and you see there's 60 to 100 pages in the chapter, you know, you get a little intimidated and sometimes you don't even read the chapter. So this way, it's so short and concise, hopefully you'll have no excuse not to read the textbook and follow along from there. If you decide you need a little more depth, you need a little more information on some topic, there are lots of traditional textbooks out there. You can flip to the right chapter and read up on that. If you're struggling with momentum, you can go to the momentum chapter. If you're struggling with energy, you can go to that chapter. Lots of textbooks out there to use. And there's one that's available for free called OpenStax. That's a free online textbook. So that's a brief introduction to how we will learn mechanics. In general, students find this method of learning physics a little bit more natural, and they claim they have a better understanding of the concepts at the end of the quarter than students that follow a traditional format. So I'm looking forward to using this approach and tackling mechanics with you.